डोंट ट्राई टू फॉरगेट द साइंटिफिक नेम्स. सो पैडिस टेम्पोरल मीन्स टिप्पोफेगा इंसेटुलस. सो दीज टर्म यू विल गेट फ्यूचर क्लासेस फ्यूचर एग्जामिनेशंस ईच एंड एवरी टाइम वेन एवर पैडी क्रॉप विल कम यू विल गेट द साइंटिफिक नेम बिकॉज दिस इज द मोनोपैगस द डेडलीस्ट पेस्ट इन द राइस. यू नो राइस हाउ इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट क्रॉप टू द वर्ल्ड. इन दट सच एन इंपॉर्टेंट क्रॉप दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट पेस्ट. ओके पैडिस टेम्पोरल ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज yellow stem borer, hence they are in yellow in color. See the color of this, yellow in color. So they are yellow stem borers, Scyphophaga insectulus. And I have shown the damage symptoms of this. So this is the dead heart. Dead heart is the major symptom of this pest. And next one is chaffy grains, white ears. So these three is the important points regarding to this pest. They are yellow stem borers, monophagous, and they will cause the symptom dead heart and as well as chaffy ear heads. The next one is green leaf hopper. So in this we have a three important species in India: viruses, Nigropicus, and Cincticeps. Out of these viruses, this is the viruses. Nephotrichs virescens is the deadliest insect which can transmit the different kind of diseases. If you see here, rice tundra virus, rice yellow dwarf virus, transistor yellowing virus, these are all viruses will be transferred by this Nephotrichs virescens. That's why this is very dangerous pest. And second one is, third one is brown plant hopper. So this is a brown plant hopper. They are brown in color and they always feed on the plant. So the scientific name is Nilparvata lugens. Nilparvata lugens. So if these insects will be affected by the rice plant, these insects will affected to the rice plant. So they will cause the hopper borne. You can see here the green color field with brown color patches. So this is the hopper borne. Then after that we have seen rice hearted bug. So the bug, this is the bug. You can see how slender and they are triangular in shape always. So this will feed on the milky grains. So when they are in milky stage, they'll suck the juice. So by that it will damage the grain and as well as it will create the chaffy grains also. So up to this we have seen, up to this bug damage we have seen. Today we will start rice gall midge. See, rice gall midge, scientific the common name is gall midge. That means the it is midge, common name is midge, and gall, it will form the galls. Galls nothing but you can see few stem regions or few leaves there with some. I will show the picture, but I cannot. If you are an expert, also you cannot imagine that. I will show you galls. What is that? Then first, before that, we can see this is the scientific name is Oreocella varese. So gall means scientific name is Oreocella varese. So you can see what is the scientific name of plant? You know, rice varieties sativa. Varieties sativa. On this, they have given this name, Varese. That means this Oreocella genus. In this genus, the species Varese is the species which can feed on the rice plant. Krishna Patel. Hey, Krishna Patel. Mute your mic. Idiots. Krishna Patel. See, Oreocella varese is a scientific name of gall midge, and this is belongs to family Cecidomyidae, and the order is Diptera. You can just imagine Diptera means how these insects are looking. This looks like a mosquito, am I right? Why does it look like mosquito means? So this is also belongs to family of Diptera. So there is a closer relationship between this midgeon as well as mosquito. What is the distribution status of this Varicella varage? They are simultaneously appear in India, Burma, Cambodia, Sri Lanka, China, Indonesia, Nigeria, Sudan, Vietnam and Pakistan. So this pest is widely distributed in the world in different countries. What is the host range of this? So this will feed on rice. Simultaneously it will feed on wild species of rice. We have a different type of wild species of rice and grasses like Persepalum, Scrobiculatum, Panicum species, Cynodon doctolon, and Eleusina indica. So what it is showing you that it is not only pest on rice, so it will be feed on different plants because this is polyphagous pest. This is not monophagous. But mostly they will like the rice. Why they are like the rice? And so this is in a food crop. So we are giving lot of nutrients. We will excessively applying the urea to get the higher yield. Because of that, leaf will become a sweet in nature. So definitely they'll attack to the rice plant because of that. This is the worst range of this. Next one is symptom of damage. How we can identify that symptom? It was affected by the Varicella varicella. You can see this picture. You can see my cursor mark. So if you observe here, the roots are there. This is the plant roots. Just above the plant root, you can see the gall symptom. If you cut that gall symptom, inside you can see the larvae of gall midge. So this is the gall, the type of symptoms. Okay. The maggot feeds at the base of the growing shoot. Always they will feed at base of the growing shoot. And the causing information of a tube-like gall that is similar to the onion leaf or silver shoot. So how they will cause the symptom? You can see the second picture. You see here. The rice leaf commonly how they are looking like, life leaf is very flat and very thin. But once this gall fly will affect it to the rice plant, what will happen? The leaves will become a like onion leaf. If you see the onion plant, how that they are look like a round in shape. Onion leaves are round in shape and they look so like that. If this gall midge will be affected to the rice plant, the thin flat leaf will be become a round and as well as they will appear like a onion shoot. So because of this damage will be named by the onion leaf, because the damaged leaf will be look like a onion leaf and also called as a silver shoot. Why silver shoot means they will become a silver in color. You can see here silver in color. Then infested tillers produce no panicles. If hence the insect will be affected to the plant, they will not produce the panicles. So you might be get one more doubt. Sir, you can see here, just above the root level, they injured and they are feeding inside the plant. So we know rice is a water loving crop. So almost the 5 centimeters of the plant stem will be always submerged into the root, into the water. How they will feed here? They'll bore into the stem and they'll start to feed into the stem. That's why they can live inside the water also, because they are not living in the water, they are living inside the stem. They'll bore the inside stem and they'll live inside. And if you see the life cycle of this, they exactly look like a mosquitoes. So in field you might be felt this may be a mosquito, not gall midge. Unless you don't know the morphological structures of that, you might be feel that this is a mosquito, big mosquito like that. So they lay the eggs they are 2 to 5 days. After that, the larvae will come out. They'll feed 10 to 20 days in the stem. Pupae, 3 to 5 days, adult will come out. Again, adults, they will live only 2 to 3 days. Again, they will lay the eggs. So the entire life cycle will be continue like this. Now we will see the how eggs are look like, larvae and pupae and all these things. So if you see the identification of insect pest, the eggs, how they are looking like eggs. So by morphology itself, we can describe this, that they are elongate, they are not round, they are elongate in shape. The fly lays elongate, cylindrical, they are cylinder in shape. Shining white or red or pinkish eggs. This white, red or pinkish will be changed based upon the species or genus of the gall midge. Eggs singly or in clusters. Sometimes they will lay singly or sometimes they will lay as a clusters also. In 2 to 6 at the base of the leaves. Base of the leaf, they lay the eggs commonly. And larvae. Maggot is 1 mm long. You can see the larvae here. In this, larvae are always not bigger ones, 1 mm long. After hatching with pointed anterior end, it creeps down the sheath and enters the growing bud. An oval chamber is formed round the site of the feeding. So this oval chamber is nothing but a gall. The oval shape, it will form a chamber. So there the gall, the rising position will come. So once if you enter into the inside, so it will start feeding inside, and because of that the rice leaf will become a look like a onion shoot and it will not produce any tillers. Then pupae and adult. You can see pupae how they are looking. At the time of emergence, the pupae wriggles up the tube with the help of antennal horn to the tip of the silver shoot and projects halfway out. See, you can see the horn here. So with the help of this horn, it will stick to the stem and it will grow inside. Adult. Adult fly is yellowish brown and mosquito-like. They are like a mosquito, you can see here. And the female is ash grey in color. Adults feed on dew drops. So once here pupae will hatch, so with the help of that gall, adult will come out. And they will start to feed on the dew drops. What is a dew drop means? In early morning hours, you can see the dew drops on the all kind of leaves. Especially in winter, you can see a lot of dew drops. The control measures. How we will control this? Now we have seen what is the gall midge, how they are looking like, where they will lay the eggs, how they will cause the damage, what is the loss of that. Now we will see how to control that gall damage. Gall midge damage in rice crop. See, control measures are cultural methods. First we have to see always cultural, mechanical, biological, then we have to go for the chemical measures. What are the cultural methods? Early plowing. So we should not do the late. If you want to grow a rice crop, go for the early plowing. Early plowing will be happen in summers. So we can call them as a summer plowing also. Early transplanting. If 30 days means variety, we have to transplant within a 30 days period. If you prolong nursery, then again infestation will be increased. Harvest the crop and plow immediately. If you once harvest the older crop, we have to plow the crop immediately. Then remove the alternate host. Therefore, I have mentioned you a lot of weeds. We have to remove the alternate host from the field sites. Then optimum recommendation of potash fertilizer. Optimum recommendation of potash fertilizer help to overcome the pest incidence. Then mechanical method. Setting of fly traps. At the rate 1 to 2 per acre. If we are growing 1 acre of flies, rice plant, just you keep 1 or 2 fly traps and monitoring the adult flies. So daily morning we have to go and monitor that. If there is any adult fly, immediately we have to go for the chemical treatment. Then biological. The releasing of Platygaster variceae. So you can see here also. Scientific name again, Platygaster variceae. This is actually egg parasite. okay, belongs to family Platygastridae. So hence this is belongs to family Platygastridae, they have given genus name Platygaster and Varisae. Hence they are laying the eggs on Varicella Varisae, they given the name here species Varisae. Platygaster Varisae is egg parasitoid. So it will parasitize on the galls. Inside the gall, eggs will be there. At 1 per 10 meter square. How we are calculating 10 meter square? You take 10 meter sticks, 10 meter length of 4 sticks and place them in a square shape. So in that much of place, we have to release single Platygaster Varisae parasitoid on 10 days after transplanting. So day DAT, always DAT will be show you days after transplanting. Then we will see chemical treatment. After doing all these things, we have to go for the chemical treatment. So root dipping of seedlings. When we will do this root dipping? When transplantation is happening, when we are pulling out the seedlings from the nursery, when we are transplanting them into the main field, we have to go for the root dipping in chlorpyrifos. The chemical is chlorpyrifos 20% EC. Emulsifiable concentration at the rate 2.5 ml per liter of water solution. Just add chlorpyrifos 2.5 ml in 1 liter of solution and just dip all the seedlings, rice seedling roots and transplant. If you do like this, we can control the gall mucus. Then apply granular insecticides. Porate or fipronil at recommended rates in seed bed, compulsorily in endemic areas. So at 20 DAT, DAT means days after transplanting. After transplanting 20, after 20 days of transplanting, in the between of June and September, if there is 5% onion leaf incidence, observe the applications of 4-8 10 gram at the rate 4 kg per acre. So if you transplanted, your root dipping you did here, again you transplanted, even though incidence is there. So at that time, what we have to do, we have to apply the 4-8 granules 10 gram per 4 kg. 4-8 10 gram at the rate 4 kg per acre. If it is 1 hectare is 10 gram, 10 kgs of 4-8 granules we have to apply into the rice field. Then fipronil 0.3 gram at the rate 7.5 kg per acre and maintaining 2 inch of standing water in the field. Okay. Then after along with this fipronil, we have to maintain the always 2 inch of standing water in the field. If you maintain that, we can reduce the gall mucus damage in the rice crop. Then next pest is swarming caterpillar. See the meaning again, swarming caterpillar. Caterpillar means the immature stages of Lepidoptera. Swarming means the moving of individuals in a group from one place to another place. So it is referring the caterpillars will be move grouply one place to another place. Swarming caterpillar, Spodoptera marussia. Scientific name is Spodoptera marussia and family Noctuidae. Noctuidae refers they are very active in night times. They will roam on night times. Noctuidae. Noctuidae means nocturnal pest. Any family comes under Noctuidae, they are very active in night times and other Lepidoptera. What is the host range? Rice, maize, jowar, wheat, barley and sorghum. See, these are all very big crops, commercially very important crops. Rice, maize, jowar, wheat, barley and sugarcane. Not only this is a polyphagous pest. It will eat all kind of things. Not only this, it will eat a lot of things. And distribution, India, Southeast Asia, USA, Australia, Africa. Almost we have a worldwide, this is worldwide known pest, Spodoptera marussia. And we have one more species, Spodoptera litura, that is also very massive pest. Now on maize we are seeing recently, what is the new species? Spodoptera fusiferida. Spodoptera fusiferida is the nowadays maize, the deadliest pest. These are all belongs to Spodoptera. But species will be changed. Spodoptera maroochia in rice, Spodoptera luteri in some other crop, Spodoptera fusifida in some other crop. So Spodoptera genus itself very dangerous. See the mouth, how they are looking. The four wings are brown in color, the abdomen entire body, except the hind wings, they are light in color. So how it will cause damage? You will see the damage symptoms now in rice. See, can you see the picture here, first picture? If you see the leaf picture, you can see the damage at sides of the leaf. Leaf blades were eaten by the caterpillars. And here you can see the entire plant is occupied by the Spodoptera luteri larvae. There is no leaves at all, except stem, nothing is there. Just see in the second picture. So now we will see how it will cause damage. So this pest causes very serious damage to young crops when it appears in large numbers. It is one or two, we don't have any problem. But when it will appear in large amount, so they will come like a locust. So they will migrate, they will grow, they used to move, they can move always in night times. If once they start, up to early morning hours they used to eat. Again they will hide on the underside of the leaves. Again they will start at night to migrate and eat. While going, it will destroy everything. The caterpillars feed at night and hide during the daytimes. Larvae cut the seedlings in large scale and appear as if grazed by cattle by its nocturnal feeding. See, if you once the insect pest is crossed over the field, if you farmer will go and see the early morning, they will think some cattle might be grazed my field. Somebody is releasing cattle, buffaloes. So the field will look like this. Just you imagine how the cattle will be fed. It will feed entire plant almost. These insects also will feel like this. Peduncles of ears are bitten through in maturing crop. Then they feed gregariously and then march from one field to another field. That's why the march, when they have a marching habit, they are swarming caterpillars. The damage is severe in July to September. It breeds on a variety of grasses. Hence they are feeding on rice, they will not continue their breeding on the rice. They will breed on variety of grasses. Whatever grass is available, they will lay the eggs on that, and larvae will feed on that also. So the thing is, we have to know the morphology characters, how they are looking. By that only we can able to identify that. The yield losses ranges from 10% to 20% in the field. So binomics. See here, this is how moths will be observed. You can see here, the last picture of this. If you open the wings, the hind wings will be look like this, very transparent. But when the moth is sitting like this, without wingspan, expand, so they are looking, the moth will be look like this. Simply they look like a bird dropping, bird shit. Bird will drop the shit, how they are looking, they look like this. So our binomic. You can see here egg mass, first fin. If you once eggs will be hatched, all the caterpillars will come out. And this is a big one. You can see the lateral lines. These lateral lines are the peculiar character of this Spodoptera luteri and pupae. They are somewhat bigger and very dark brown. You can identify them very easily. So adult moth is medium sized, stoutly built, and dark brown with a conspicuous triangular spot on four wings. Then eggs are laid in mosses on leaves and covered with grey hairs. You can see here. They laid in group and they are covered with grey hair. The egg period is 7 days. After 7 days, the caterpillars will be come out. The caterpillar is cylindrical, dark to pale green, with lateral lines along the body. The larvae period is 20 to 25 days. 7 days is egg period. If you are unable to identify them in egg stage itself, if you spray within a week, you can control this pest. The next one is larval period. They will grow 20 to 25 days, almost a month. it prepares in a earthen cocoon in soil for 12 to 15 days. So, the pupal period is 10 to 15 days. So, if you can able to control them in larval stage within a month, that is good. After that, it will become a pupae and it will enter into the soil. So, when they are in pupal stage, we have to apply the granules or we have to inject the insecticides into the soil. Foliar application will not use. The next one is management. So, conserve natural parasites. They are telling conservation. Conservation means what? How we can conserve, now how the people are conserving tigers or some rare tortoise, some rare animals. How we are conserving? So, we are bringing them from the forest. We are making them all the facilities. And we are avoiding their predators of the particular animal. And we are creating all the environment. If they are loving water, we are giving water, love water. If they are loving trees, we are growing trees in the places. So like that, here we have to conserve the these following parasites in our field. For this conservation, what we have to do? So we should not remove the, all the weeds. Whatever is the alternate host, that weeds only we have to remove. Remaining weeds we have to be allowed. That weed will be give the shelter to the parasite. Parasite also insect. They are also having a hiding habit. So if you maintain the necessary weeds in the field, what will happen? Parasites will be hiding that, and whenever they want, they'll come out and they'll feed on the sporoprolytra, egg or pupae or larvae. So what are like? I have given here the lot of larval parasites, Apentalis and Metaurus, Charpos bicolor, Charpos dominans, here Dryno species, Pseudopericata, like this you can just read. There is a lot of larval parasites are available here. Then conserve pupal parasites. These are all the larval parasites. Here pupal parasites, Nitilia species, Actia species, Dryno species, and Isomera senescensis. So these are all the pupal parasites. Don't try to remember all these things. It's very difficult and you will be confused also. So after completion of this course means rice, after completion of every crop, I'll give that 30 to 40 important bits. So they are the important ones for your exams and as well as the future competitive examinations also. Already I have given for last semester also economic entomology. Like that I will give the bits. If you can prepare from them, that is more than enough. Don't try to remember all these things, you will get confused. So spray chlorpyrifos 20 EC 80 ml plus 20 liter of water for 8 cents. If you spray this also, we can able to control. Then protect vertebrate predators of the larvae. Just imagine vertebrate predators, that means birds. Birds are vertebrate predators. What are all the predators they have given here? House crow, jungle crow, see, cattle egret, Indian pond finnora, paddy bird, white-breasted water hen, Indian mynah also very common. So these are all birds will help you to pick up the larvae from the field. For this, what we have to do? We have to create the shelter in the field, at least standing place, because that is a rice field. The underground is everything with a lot of water, plenty of water, and rice plant also the not much of strong. So bird cannot sit on the plant and as well as in the land. So in that we have to give the bird patches. Bird patches are nothing but a T-shaped wooden material. Keep one stick in straight position, another one is lateral position on that. Just tie it, it will become a T-shape. So on that birds will visit and it will feed on the larvae. Then flood the nursery to expose the hiding larvae to the surface for birds to pick them up. Then kerosinate water during irrigation to suffocate and kill the larvae. When we are giving the irrigation to the rice, you just mix some kerosene in that. So if you mix like this, then the larvae will not get the respiration and it will die. Allow ducks into the field. You know the ducks, am I right? So the ducks always will be living in the water. They like the water. And they will feed everything in the water. So just allow the ducks, 100 or 200 or 300, they are coming as a, they come always as a mass. Just allow them 1 hour or 2 hours in our field. So it will eat all the insect larvae. So drain water from nursery and spray chlorpyrifos 20 EC 80 ml or endosulfan 35 EC 80 ml during the late evenings. See, just you see here, this is a very important thing. During what to apply, how much we have to apply, when to apply. What to apply? Chlorpyrifos, endosulfan we have to apply. When we have to apply? During the late evenings. Don't apply in afternoons or early mornings. Late evening stage, what will happen? So the late evening stage after that, that is we used to call as scientifically crepuscular time. Crepuscular time. So after 6, the larvae will come, start to come out and they'll feed on the leaves. If apply the insecticide during late evening, so the efficacy of insecticide is good and it will eat by the larvae. Larvae will killed by the insecticide. The next pest is leaf folder. So just imagine the name, leaf folder. That means it will fold the leaf. You can see the image. Commonly rice leaves are straight and thin. So how they are folding? How they are folding the leaf? See, you just imagine this is the one end, this is one end. So it will try to tie the leaves one end to another end. Like that it will construct with the help of silk. Last year we have seen the insects will produce the silk. With the help of that silk, it will tie the both the ends of the leaf and it will make a tunnel. So they will remain inside the tunnel and they will start the feeding. So when they are inside, then they are feeding inside the tunnels, you can see the scratches on the leaves, white color scratches. They will scrap the chlorophyll. Okay. So what is the leaf folder scientific name? Staphylococcus medinalis. Staphylococcus medinalis. There belongs to family Pyralidae, order Lepidoptera. So distribution and status. So there India, Sri Lanka, China, Japan, Madagascar, New Guinea, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Southeast Asia, Korea. Host range is grasses also. Not only rice, grasses. So damage symptoms. So the caterpillar folds the leaves longitudinally and remains inside. It scraps the green tissue of the leaf and makes them white and dry. You can see. Don't scrap the green color leaves, they'll become white and dry. During the severe infestation, the whole field exhibits scratched appearance. So everywhere in all the fields, if ETL, the pest infestation level is below 10%, nothing will happen. When the any pest will cause the economic loss, when they are in severe forms. So in that severe form, if they create the damage, entire field look like a unhealthy. So if you imagine this kind of larvae, so many will come, then the entire leaf will be become like this, entire crop. So the field look like a awkward. So if it will happen once, the photosynthesis capacity will be reduced in the field. So automatically field will get yield loss, farmer end up loss. So this is a leaf folder. Then biodynamics, how they are looking. See how beautiful the moth is. Very beautiful and very small also. We can very easily to identify them after seeing this morphology. Even in Shirpur region, in our campus also, I have seen this kind of moth, even maybe they are not feeding on rice, but they are feeding on some other grasses. I try to collect and I'll show you if you want to come back to campus. So if you see the dynamics, the adult moth is often seen in the field during daytime. See that daytime, that means they are not nocturnal, they are diurnals. These leaves are will be, these pests will be roaming daytime. The moth is brownish with many dark wavy lines in center and dark band on marginal of wings. So this is the dark band. You can see here band. This is the band. The female moth lays eggs in batches of 10 to 12. So these are all the eggs, which are arranged in linear row in the lower surface of the leaf. The eggs are flat. They are flat, somewhat oval in shape and yellowish white in color. They are yellowish white in color. The egg period is 4 to 7 days. Within a week, they will start to emerge. Larvae will come out. You see the larvae, how they look like. This is the fecal matter of the larvae. So this is the pupae. You can see here the folded leaf. The common leaf is like this, but it is folded like this. And the pupate also will happen inside the leaf. Here larvae is 15 to 20 mm long, pale green, transparent. See the length, 15 to 20 mm, millimeters. Pale green, transparent, actively moving caterpillar. They are very active. Yes, the statement is true. You try to touch them, they will move very fast and very active also. The larvae period is 15 to 20 days. It pupates inside the leaf fold. You can see the fold of here, leaf fold. They will pupate inside the leaf fold. The pupae is greenish brown. So this is greenish brown, they are telling. The pupal period is 6 to 8 days. The total life cycle is 25 to 35 days. Within 25 to 1 month, they will complete their life cycle. Again, they will start to lay the eggs. So how to manage this? Management. So use Western varieties like TNAU. TNAU nothing but a Tamil Nadu Agricultural University. TNAU LFR 831-311, Kaveri, Akshi, TKM6, IET7511, IET9225 and IET9797, ASD20, VC Dana 2221, PTP12, PTP20, PT321, H4. These are all the resistant varieties. How it will become a resistant? So resistant comes under in different ways: antigenosis and antibiosis. Antibiosis means because of the inert chemical of plants, inert juices of plant, the pest will be deterred by the plant. Antigenosis means morphological characters. Because of that morphological characters, the insect will not like to feed on the leaf. Okay. Then clipping of affected leaves reduce the pest population. If you've seen any folding leaf, you just clip. Clipping that leaves and throw it out, burn it out. So with that we can reduce the insect infestation in field. Trim the buns and remove grassy weeds. Always we have to trim the buns. Then avoid use of excessive nitrogen fertilizers. This excessive use of nitrogen fertilizers is the main mistake what farmers will do always. Farmers will think if you just apply the lot of nitrogen fertilizer, the yield will come up very good. Because of that, pest also will come up very good in that field. That is our duty to inform to the farmers, don't use excess nitrogenous fertilizers. Then set up light traps to attract and kill the moth. So always setting up light traps are good ideal method to kill the traps and kill the pest and as well as to monitor also. So release Trichogroma chylonosis. The Trichogroma chylonosis is egg parasite, belongs to family Trichogrammatidae. Three times on 37th, 44th and 51 date after transplanting. If you feel that this pest is very heavy in your field, after 51 days of transplanting, that means almost 2 years, after 2 months, sorry, after transplanting, first we have to release after 31 days, next one is after 44 days, next one is after 51 days. If you release this Trichogramma calensis, so it will control somewhat. After that, we will go for the three sprays of Monocrotopus, 36 SL, 1 liter per hectare on 58, 65 and 72 dates. In 37, 44, 51 days, we have to release the Trichogramma calensis. After 58, 65, 72 days, we have to take the Monocrotopus chemical treatment into the crop. After that, apply. So there is a Cartop and Benfrocarb, these are all the granules. Cartop hydrochloride. So 4G granules. Wherever the G will come, they refers the granule. That insects are not liquid form or powder form, they are in granule form. 1.875 to 2.5 kg per hectare. Spray any of the following insecticide in 500 ml water per hectare. 500 liter of water per hectare. See, here they have given plenty of insecticides. NSKE. NSKE means neem seed kernel extract. Neem seed, kernel extract, chlorpyrifos, acephate, ethofenoprox, azadirachtin, fipronil, again azadirachtin, here 0.150, here 5% is fasolone, cartap hydrochloride, phosphomedon, flubendamide, lambda cyclothrin, okay, chlorantrinoprol, corazin, this is corazin, thiomethoxam. So you can apply any one of these insecticides. I have given ratios also here to control the rice leaf folder. So next we will see rice case swarm. See, if you observe the first image, you can see the case here. So inside this case, the larvae will be remain inside and it will start to feed. You can see below one more picture, you can see the multiple cases on the leaves. To make that, their eating is very few, the lower amount, but their wasting is very much. To make this case, so you can see a few leaves are floating on the water. They'll cut the leaf and they'll make a case. So that is a nest for that insect, and remaining they are staying inside and they start to feed on the leaves. So to make the case itself, it will cut lot of leaves and it will damage the crop. One or two means no problem, but if it is with more in number means it will cut entire field. The rice case form scientific name is Nymphola dupunctalis. Nymphola dupunctalis, Pyrasteridae family, Lepioptera order. The distribution, India, Southeast Asia, Australia. Host plant is rice. So damage symptoms. The caterpillar feed on green tissue of the leaf and form tubular cases around them by cutting the apical portion of the leaves, which float on water. Several tubes are also seen hanging from the plants. So you can see here. Then in case of severe infestation, plants are unable to grow. The damaged leaf tips, the typical portion of cut leaves bear whitish papery areas since the chlorophyll scrap. So the daily it is cutting the terminal portions, how plant will grow? Plant will not grow, how panicle will come, seed will come, flowers will come. So such a kind of damage it will do. Then binomics. You can see here, first in images, see the eggs of this, larvae of this, pupae, and adult, and damage. So adult is a delicate white moth, you can see here, they are white and very delicate, with the pupal brown, wavy markings. Eggs are laid on leaves, Egg period is 2 to 6 days. You can see the egg here. Then larvae is pale transparent green with orange head. This is the larvae. Larvae constructs a case. This is a case. Larval period is 14 to 20 days. They are remaining inside the case and they will feed on the plant 14 to 20 days. The larvae has filamentous gills on the side of the body that helps to lead a semi-aquatic leaf. See, actually, the what are all the insects are growing on earth, they have a tracheal gills to respire. What are all the larvae or adults are staying inside the water, they have a gills. So here they have a filamentous gills on sides. Even they are feeding in plants, when they have a filamentous gills, whenever they fall down into the water, they'll help to breathe. It pupates in case itself for 4 to 7 days. So after feeding, after maturing larvae, they'll get the pupae also. This is the pupae inside the leaf. And they will hatch after the 4 to 7 days. The total life cycle occupies 19 to 37 days to complete this full of life cycle. Then how to manage? Management is the conserved larval parasites, Elasmus, Apatellus, Brachon. If you listen my class properly, last time I have explained that what are all the families and superfamilies of parasites, how the differentiate of the characters also. I have explained in the board. So these are all the parasitic genus. I have explained to you last semester up to family level. Now we are seeing all the species and genus level. Elasmus, Apatellus, Brachon, these are all the larval parasitic insects. Conserved people parasites. What are the people parasites? Pidiobius, Aphislopis, Ipteromallus, Pernarere. The pronunciation itself very difficult. To remember also very difficult, am I right? So there is a need of daily reading of scientific names. You have to read daily, otherwise it is very difficult to remember. Then drain water from the field. To control this, we have to drain the water from the field simultaneously. Dislodge the case by running a rope over the young crop. This is a very important practice. Actually, there are cases, they made a cases. You take the one big rope. So two ends of the rope will be pulled by the two persons. And they'll start to running a rope on the over the field. So when they are going like that, if any cases are there, they'll touch through that rope and it will fall down into the water. Spray endosulfan 35 EC or monocrotophos 36 SL, 1 liter or phenothreate 50 EC, 1 liter in 500 ml of water, 500 liter of water. So this 35 EC, 36 SL, these are all the strength of the chemical. After seeing the strength, after seeing the volume, and after knowing our area of application, then we have to recommend the insecticide, how much we have to add to the 1 liter. That I will explain in the practical class. So always insecticide bottle with the strength and their volume. With that we have to convert. So if you are using one kind of sprayer, how much ml of insecticide we have to add to the 1 liter. It is 1 ml or 2 ml or 3 ml per liter recommendation is there, no? So I will explain you in practical class how to recommend that insecticide. So this is about the rice case form. So we will wind up today with this, and tomorrow by this time again I will take the entomology class. So remaining the pest we will cover in the class. So now this is open for discussion. If anybody have any doubts, you can ask me. If anybody any doubts, you can there is any problem in PowerPoint appearing or anything, the class is wind up now. If anybody having any doubts, you can, I'll be in the online another 2-3 minutes. If you have any doubts, just you can contact. But guys, if you have any doubts, I think everybody, at least one student, at least.
No, sir.
They can respond. You don't have any doubts?
No, Aish? Sir. No, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Aish, you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Any problem in PowerPoint presentation and all these things? Everything is clear?
Yes, sir.
So I am moving my cursor whenever I am explaining symptom or anything. You are saying that?
Yes, sir.